Good morning on this Christ the King Sunday. You are listening to a live broadcast from Lutheran Memorial Church in Pierre. Lutheran Memorial is located at the corner of Nicollet and Prospect, just west of the state capitol. Today's radio broadcast is sponsored by Esther Schluter in honor of the Lutheran Memorial Church musicians. The pastor at Lutheran Memorial is Senior Pastor Craig Wexler. Special music will be provided this morning by Marla Amundson, Jamie Werner, and Rod Bauck. Today's organist is Lori Kennecke. Hymn numbers this morning are 434, 679, 685, and 855. Our service is about to begin, and our opening hymn is Jesus Shall Reign, number 434 in the ELW hymnal.
Let all mortal flesh keep silent, and with fear and trembling stand. Ponder nothing earthly minded, for with blessing in his hand, Christ our God to earth descending, comes full homage to demand. King of kings, yet born of Mary, as of old on earth he stood. Lord of lords in human vesture, in the body and the blood, he will give to all the faithful his own self for heavenly food. Rank on rank the host of heaven spreads its vanguard on the way, as the light of light descending from the realms of endless day, comes the powers of hell to vanquish, as the darkness clears away. At his feet the six-winged seraph, cherubim with sleepless eye, veil their faces to the presence, as with ceaseless voice they cry, Alleluia, 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 Lord Most High.
Thank you, Rod, Marla, and Jamie. Good morning. morning and glad to have you guys on this Christ the King Sunday. Christ the King Sunday is the last Sunday of the church calendar year, which means next week we begin our journey of Advent and the... Excuse me, I was about to choke on my spit. That's a joyous moment. Whew. And Advent is, of course, when we start the lighting of our Advent wreath and enter into the journey towards Christmas. So glad to have all of you guys here this morning. We have good news. We ran out of bulletin announcements. That's a good problem to have. With that being said, if you did not get one, just jump online for any announcements. There is one I want to point out, those of you that do have it, the Children's Christmas Program. It looks like the rehearsal and the day of are the same day. That is incorrect. The rehearsal is the Saturday morning. The program is that Sunday evening, December 9th, 10th, whatever those dates are. We are going to get that corrected for next week's bulletin, but just know that the rehearsal is correct. The program is the Sunday evening at 4 p.m. So glad to have that in front of you. If you have any questions, certainly reach out. We do still have the job opening for maintenance janitor. If you are interested or you know anyone that would be interested, reach out at any time and let's have a conversation. But with that being said, let's set aside announcements. Let us join into our time of worship together. I invite those who are able to please rise. Let us begin our worship as we always do with the confession of our sin and hearing the promise of God's mercy. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. We begin with a moment of silence to reflect. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our gathering hymn is Jesus Shall Reign, number 434 in our red hymnals.
Shall reign. Dwell on his love.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Be with you.
And also with you.
Let us join together in our prayer of the day. O God of power and might, your Son shows us the way of service, and in him we inherit the riches of your grace. Give us the wisdom to know what is right, and the strength to serve the world that you have made. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
First reading today is from Ezekiel.
It's chapters 34, verses 11 through 16, and verses 20 through 24. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out, as shepherds seek out their flocks when they are among their scattered sheep. So I will seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries, and I will bring them into their own land. And I will feed them on the mountains of Israel, by the watercourses, and in all the inhabited parts of the land. I will feed them with good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel shall be their pasture. There they shall lie down in good grazing land, and they shall feed on rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak, but the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. Therefore, says the Lord God to them, I myself will judge between the fat sheep and the lean sheep, because you pushed with flank and shoulder and butted at all the weak animals with your horns until you scattered them far and wide. I will save my flock, and they shall no longer be ravaged. And I will judge between sheep and sheep. I will set up over them one shepherd, my servant David, and he shall feed them. He shall feed them and be their shepherd, and I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David shall be prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is Psalm 95, verses 1 through 7a. Please read responsively. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before God's presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to the Lord with psalms.
For you, Lord, are a great God and a great ruler above all gods.
In your hand are the caverns of the earth, the heights of the hills are also yours.
The sea is yours, for you made it, and your hands have molded the dry land. For the Lord is our God, and we are the people of God's pasture and the sheep of God's hand. The second reading is from Ephesians chapter 1, verses 15 through 23. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love toward all the saints. And for this reason, I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that, with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the Alleluia verse and the reading of the Gospel.
Alleluia, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia, Alleluia.
Our Holy Gospel comes to us today from the book of Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Matthew chapter 25, verses 31 to 46. Now Jesus said to the disciples, when the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? When was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you? And the king will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me. Then he will say to those in his left hand, you that are accursed, depart from me into the eternal fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not give me clothing. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit me. Then they also will answer, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not take care of you? Then he will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. We're finally at the end of the parables. It is in this moment in Matthew's gospel where all of the parables come to an end. And it's after these words this morning in which the leaders of the synagogue will begin their plot against Jesus. It's fascinating that it is this text that is what's prescribed, so to speak, for the Christ the King Sunday. It is this text in which, quite frankly, we hear just that, a prescription of sorts. What do you mean by a prescription, Pastor? Well, over the last few weeks, we've had these parables that clearly delineate who is chosen and who is not, who is in and who is out. And we really, deep down inside, are discomforted by these texts. And again, we have this before us. I actually can't stand the NRSV's translation at the end. The NIV says this, He will reply, I tell you the truth, whatever you did not do for one of the least of these, you did not do for me. Then they will go away to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. It's a prescription in our minds. Because many of us sitting here are wondering, am I a sheep or am I a goat? Am I on the right or am I on the left? And a couple weeks ago, the 10 bridesmaids, am I one with the extra oil, or am I the one running to the market? Am I in? Am I out? Am I saved, or am I damned? In our mind, these are the words we hear, and these are the ways that our thoughts already begin, because we want the prescription. We want exactly the steps that it takes for us to be the sheep. Amen? We love prescriptions. We survive on prescriptions. 2 years ago, I remember our journey with our daughter in her health journey. 2 years ago, what started with an ankle injury that just didn't seem to heal led it to doctor after doctor, a second opinion to a third opinion, walking to the Mayo Clinic system in Rochester. And when it was all said and done, what we had at the end of it was a prescription. What we had was the answer to the situation. Now, my daughter, she'll never be healed because there is no cure for her condition, but we have a prescription, we have a lifestyle, we have an answer that will save her. And for my wife and I, we are glad. Amen? Any of us that have been in the journey of life in which we have a prescription given to us to help us know exactly what it is to have one one more day, one more week, one more month, one more year, of course, is viewed as a gift. But that's because we long to control the outcome. And there are certain aspects of our life where, yes, indeed, we can control the outcome. But when it comes to these parables, nothing about the parables is us controlling the outcome. The answer we're longing for comes in the King, the Great Shepherd. So we dive into this parable, we dive into this text, and we hear this division, so to speak. It is Jesus. If you were to go into my Bible, you would have four pages in a row of nothing but red letters. If you have any idea what I'm talking about, the red letters in some Bibles is all of Jesus' words that he said. Four pages in a row, uninterrupted by black ink, all red letters of Jesus prescribing in theory what we believe to be who is saved and who is not. And he jumps right in, and his last parable just cuts to the core. Some of you will be sheep. Those of you who have fed the hungry. Those of you who have given drink to the thirsty. Those of you who have given shelter to the homeless. Those of you who visited someone in the hospital, who visited someone in the prison. You are the sheep that will be brought in and made righteous to God's right hand. But I also love the caveat in this parable. And the sheep respond, well, dear Lord, when did we feed the hungry? When did we give drink to the thirsty? When did you notice that we did this? And we find ourselves scratching our heads. And then he jumps in, and those of you who are the goats, you are the ones that never did any of these things. And their response is, quite frankly, one in the same. But when did we see you naked and didn't clothe you? When did we not feed you when you were hungry? Again, we're missing the point. We miss the point because when I look out at all of us, we are all goats. I know that's harsh. Pastor, did you just declare that we're all condemned? No. The reality is, even the sheep amongst us who think, yep, I'm a sheep. I'm a sheep. I'm benevolent. In fact, I increased my tithe to the church this year, my pledge card. We're good. Yep. You know, I've been to the prison once in a while. I've gone down there. I've taken a trip over there, and you know, Southeast Methodist down the road. Every chance we get, we'll go participate. And that, I think, dear pastor, I think I'm a sheep, you know? Rod, I think I'm a sheep. Paul, I think I made the cut, right? And then Jesus says this. He says, I tell you the truth, whatever you did not do for one, bam, end of game. For one, the one guy with the cardboard sign on the exit ramp. The one gentleman. That was it. I guess I'm no longer a sheep. I'm the goat. And for the goats, we just continue on in our wayward path in life. We've got it all figured out. Goats are notorious for going out on their own. They aren't as interested in following the rest of the flock. They're going to do it their way, and they've got the horns to defend, and what they're going to do is they're going to butt their heads. But then we end up paraphrasing this parable right there with Ezekiel. What did we hear in Ezekiel? In Ezekiel, God's judgment doesn't even include the goats on that version. His judgment is purely on the sheep. And what is his judgment upon? It is the skinny, thin, the sheep that weren't ever given the opportunity to have sustenance and the resources. In fact, God brings great judgment upon the fatted sheep, the one that always nudged the other sheep off to the side so that it could get the green, luscious grass. Any of you have multiple pets? Multiple dogs, maybe? I love dogs. I used to be a cat guy only because I grew up in a cat family. Cats are just unique. You know, we should just make this cats and dogs, parable of the cats and dogs. God forgive me, right? He didn't talk about cats and dogs. He talked about goat and sheep. If you have multiple dogs, I've witnessed from time to time, and I talked to some of our hunting guides out there that have to feed multiple labs. It's interesting to watch them absolutely butt the other one out of the way to go to their dish, right? That's exactly what is happening in Ezekiel. So whether you are the sheep or whether you're the goat, we are all judged because we missed the one. You see, Jesus isn't concerned with our tally chart. He's not concerned with our list of justifications. He's concerned about the one thin, scrawny sheep in the flock that's been pushed and pushed and nudged all the way outside and who has become lost and has gone wayward. That is the one sheep that the great shepherd is going to seek out. What happens when we hear these parables is we, in our minds, start to view Jesus as Moses in certain ways. Well, what do we mean by that? What this parable is speaking to is exactly the law, which is what Jesus has been talking to all throughout these parables. He's talking to the scribes, he's talking to the Sadducees, the Pharisees, the chief priests. All throughout these parables, as he is approaching that Passover meal, he is sitting there speaking to those who have mastered the law, to those who have spent their calling, their righteousness, believing that it is their job to delineate the sheep from the goats. And Jesus reminds them that there are a whole host of the thin, scrawny sheep all throughout Israel that have been butt out of the pasture and ignored. And what Jesus is saying, that the law is not going to save you. The law is not going to save any of the sheep. The law is not going to prevent you from being a goat and now suddenly entering into the kingdom by your adherence to it. Because if that were the case, they are failing miserably, is what Jesus is getting at. Moses was given God's law. Moses, as they left the captivity in Egypt, Moses was called up onto Sinai, and he was literally given God's law as a gift. And that law was given to prevent all of the Israelites from harming themselves and harming others. But even while, the irony is, even while Moses is up on top of Sinai receiving that law, what are the deer, sheep, and goats down below on the hillside doing? They're already creating their golden calf to worship. Because here's a hint. If you have to create something out of your own hands, you probably don't need to worship it. Amen? There's this great meme that I saw this past week. And it's different cultures all around the world at different atrocities in life carrying their gods literally on their shoulders and in their arms out of their community as they run from earthquakes and volcanoes. And as inappropriate as the joke might be, if you have to carry your God to safety, maybe it's a God not worshiping. Amen? And that's exactly what we're getting at in our text. The law that God gives is to protect you from yourself and to protect you from others and to worship the God that put all of his creatures in the pasture. And when we treat Jesus as though he is Moses, he is nothing other than another human being with great honors given by God. Moses had his role, and that law was to establish boundaries. And those boundaries were set for the sake of community and keeping God at the center of all things. The problem is we go astray. The problem is we become goats. So in this parable, on this Christ the King Sunday, Jesus is not the giver of the law any longer. Jesus is the fulfillment of the law. The interesting irony here is Christ the King Sunday is barely a century old. The Holy Church created the title of this Sunday at the turn of the 20th century in the midst of World War I and in the in-between phases of World War II. Because what the church saw was a bunch of corrupt shepherds that were deeming through tyranny and dictatorship, the rise of dictatorship, The church was discovering that what we are doing is creating a bunch of false kingships to follow, a bunch of false leadership models to follow. And what the church wanted to bring back into the front and center is the King of all kings that we are called to worship, the Great Shepherd. And the role of that Great Shepherd was to seek out the lost sheep. So our King is not Moses. Our King is our Savior. So as we gather in this space today, maybe the image we must think about is a king on his throne at the right hand of his Father, the Creator. And as we, goats, come to our moment in which we are standing there and he is separating us, one from the left, one to the right, it is in Christ and his absolute gift of mercy. It is in Christ and his eternal willingness to give us the opportunity of salvation, to grant to us the gift, the word of promise. It is that mercy seat. It is Christ in his throne that takes all of us goats and then instead names us the sheep. All of us sheep are the ones that he seeks out. All of us sheep were once lost. All of us sheep have either butted other sheep to the side or were the sheep butted to the side that are brought back into righteousness and fulfillment of all goodness that God hoped for. That is our King. But for those of us still sitting here wondering, I don't know, Pastor, I think this week I'm a sheep. I think I was on my best behavior at the Thanksgiving dinner table this week. I think I made the cut, Pastor. No, you didn't. Because there's one that we have forgotten. There will always be one on this side of the grave that we have forgotten. But our King on the throne, he gives us promises, a list of promises while we continue in the pasture. And for Augustus here in a moment, his first promise is given here in the waters. It's a beautiful gift. This is my third baptism in a row. We've got two more to go, right? This year is a record on both sides for me as a pastor. And yes, I'm making it all about me for 1 second. I have buried more people this year than I've ever done in 1 year. And that's hard. We grieve with those families, but what we also did is we ushered them into the pasture, the eternal pasture, in which that shepherd finally gives them rest. And this year is also the record number of years standing at this font. And it's not over yet. I just had another email over the weekend asking for another baptism date. So Augustus receives those words of promise today. Those promises, Augustus one day when he meets God at the throne, it's those words, you are receiving mercy. You are a son of God. You are in my pasture. And all the rest of us goats, we continue at the table in which we hear those words, you are forgiven. This is my body. This is my blood given for you. That king stands from his throne and he says, you too are sheep in my pasture. This is the King we worship. This is the King that enters us into Advent. Thanks be to God. Amen. Our hymn of the day is For the Fruit of All Creation, number 679 in a red hymnals, number 679. I invite those who are able to please rise.
Just reward.
done. In our worldwide task of caring for the hungry and despairing, in the harvests we are sharing, God's will is done. For the harvests of the Spirit, thanks be to God.
Congregation may be seated. And together we come together in the sacrament of holy baptism for Augustus Chan. I feel so bad. He's sleeping so good. It's okay. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the baptized in the one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to have Augustus baptized into Christ? If so, answer, we do. As you bring Augustus to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with him among God's faithful people, to bring him to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, teach him the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, to place in his hands the Holy Scriptures and nurture him in faith and prayer so that Augustus may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others in the world God made, and to work for justice and peace. Do you promise to help Augustus grow in the Christian faith and life? If so, answer, we do. Sponsors, do you boys promise to nurture Augustus in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help him live in the covenant of baptism in the communion with the church? If so, answer, we do. Members of Lutheran Memorial Church, people of God, do you promise to support Augustus and pray for him in his new life in Christ? If so, answer, we do. I ask us to profess our faith in Christ Jesus, to reject sin and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? I renounce them. Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? I renounce them. Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? I renounce them. Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Mom, if you want to lean him on over. Augustus Chan, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. With this oil, we anoint you with the cross of Christ forever. Here you go, Mom. You can dab his head. Guys. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give your daughters and sons new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Augustus with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. This time, Augustus, I'd like your baptismal candle, the promises in baptism certainly are never a symbol, but the candle, we light this as a symbol to remind us of God's promise. In John's Gospel, he says that he is the light that shines in the darkness, and the darkness will never overcome it. Augustus, I hope and pray that there is never a day in your life in which the darkness is overcoming of the light. But we receive that promise with joy. And Augustus, child of God, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit, marked with the cross of Christ forever. Let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Let us welcome the newly baptized with these words together. We welcome you into the body of Christ here at Lutheran Memorial and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. Let us give a round of applause to the newest little guy. We'll pass around the offering plates. For the rest of us, we will prepare ourselves for a time of prayer and the Holy Communion.
Take my life that I may be consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my hands and let them move at the and let them be swift and beautiful for Thee. Take my voice and let me sing, always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from my silver and my gold, not a mite would I withhold. Take my intellect and use every power as Thou shalt choose. Take my will and make it Thine, it shall be Thine own, it shall be Thy royal throne. Take my love, my Lord, I pour, at Thy feet its treasure store. Take myself and I will be ever and give us a
foretaste of the feast to come.
Merciful Father, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Lord God, we ask you to enter in the world this day, and we ask you to bring us to your throne. As there are voices and movements of people all over the country and all over the world that are vying to be the sheep, vying to determine who it is that is more righteous than others, Lord, humble all of us and bring us to the throne of your Son, our Lord and Savior. You are the King who sits at the right hand of our Father. You have given us your promises of identity and forgiveness in you. Let us be at peace, knowing that we will never be able to turn ourselves into the sheep of the parable of our own doing. But let us hear your word and hear your promises of love and mercy. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of creation, we ask you to be with all the people of the world this day and bring wholeness to the body of Christ. We give thanks for this holiday weekend. I pray that we have been reminded of the blessings you have given us. We pray for the days and weeks ahead as we are reminded of your greatest blessing ever given to us, your Christ child. The Prince of Peace was sent into this world to grant us mercy and everlasting life. I pray that this peace could fully be lived in this world one day, and we pray for the hostages being released in Gaza. We pray for the families who will never see loved ones again. We pray that politicians can negotiate mercy while we also are making appropriate decisions for sovereignty and dignity. We pray for our leaders to do the same, to negotiate for all to experience the hope and value of dignity we once knew so clearly. Lord, in your mercy. God of strength and healing, we ask you to continue being present with all the families on our prayer list, especially Guy Rapp, Miles Hupp, Keith Skrondahl, Lorraine Elwine, and Stacy Smith. Give them peace and comfort amongst their struggles. And we also lift up the family of Melvin Cunningham and Christina Garrett in the loss of their loved ones this past week. We pray for their comfort in your resurrection promises. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks. He broke it. He gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he gave thanks. He gave it. He took the cup. He gave thanks. He gave it for all to drink. And he said, "In this cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." As we gather at this table, let us gather in the prayer that our Lord first taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. All are welcome to this table. Communion today is through intinction. You'll be handed the wafer. You can dip it into the chalice. The red liquid is the wine. The clear is the grape juice. If you need the gluten-free option, that is front and center as you come in through the line. Again, all are welcome to this table. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy. Sin of the world, grant resist my tears. Frightened and you relieved my fears. I was unheard, you listened to.
May the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and forever keep you in his peace. Amen. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. And we pray that in your mercy you would strengthen us through this gift in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
The Lord bless you.
Creator of the rolling
peace, to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen.
This concludes our Sunday morning worship service from Luther Memorial Church in Pierre. Join us for worship on Sunday mornings at 9 o'clock a.m., Saturday evenings at 5:30 p.m. for our contemporary service, or Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. If you are unable to attend any of our three worship services, you are invited to tune into our live radio broadcast at 9 a.m. each Sunday morning on KGFX 1060 AM, 103.1 FM, or on drgnews.com by clicking Listen Live. Sunday and Wednesday services are also live streamed on our LMC Facebook page. You can catch our sermon podcasts on an app of your choice or right on our website under the Media tab. Our radio broadcasts rely on financial support from members of Lutheran Memorial and other regular listeners and viewers. If you would like to sponsor a radio broadcast in honor of a special occasion or in memory of a loved one, please contact the church office at 224-8608. On behalf of Pastor Craig Wexler and the congregation of Lutheran Memorial, we extend our prayers to you and yours for God's care and guidance throughout the coming week.